boys and girls. We're so glad you joined us today. Today, our theme is about growing up in God. And that takes a whole lot of...
change. Just like the caterpillar becoming...
a butterfly. But growing up in God always takes holiness and faithfulness. Those are big concepts. So to start off today, we're going to read you a story.
It's the story called The Very Hungry Caterpillar.
And it's my favorite.
Mine too.
Well, here we go. In the light of the moon, a little egg lay on a leaf.
One Sunday morning, the warm sun came up, and pop, out came from the egg a tiny and yet very hungry caterpillar.
Well, he started to look for some food. On Monday, he ate through an apple, but he was still hungry.
On Tuesday, he ate through two pears, but he was still hungry.
On Wednesday, he ate through three plums, but he was still hungry.
Wow. On Thursday, he ate through four strawberries, but he was still hungry.
On Friday, he ate five oranges, but he was still hungry.
And on Saturday, he ate through one piece of chocolate cake, one ice cream cone, one pickle, one slice of Swiss cheese, one slice of salami,
one lollipop, one piece of cherry pie, one sausage, one cupcake, and one slice of watermelon.
And that night?
He had a very sore stomachache. That's a lot of food.
The next day was Sunday again. The caterpillar ate through one nice green leaf, and after that, he felt much better.
Now he wasn't hungry anymore, and he wasn't a little caterpillar anymore. He was a big, fat caterpillar.
My goodness. He built a small house called a cocoon around himself, and he stayed inside for more than 2 weeks. Then he nibbled a hole in the cocoon
and pushed his way out, and what? He was a beautiful butterfly.
Wow, that's beautiful.
You know, Pastor Sarah, we all are in process of change, right? Growing up in God takes a journey. Mm. And today, as we journey with you, we hope you grow and become beautiful, just like God made you.
But I just thank you, Father, for making me, me.
kids. It's good to see you. It's Super Science with Super Sarah. I'm so glad you're back. Today we're going to do something really cool. I remember one time we used baking soda and vinegar and we made a really huge mess. And I'm sure you had a great time at home, right? Well, today we're using the same thing, but we're doing something very different. The theme for today is growing up in God and becoming holy and being faithful to God. And I want to talk to you more about that as we do this fun experiment. So, boys and girls, do you know anything about caterpillars and butterflies? Because when I think of growing up in God, I think about the fact that I change whenever I grow in God. And I cannot think of a better example than caterpillars and butterflies. Because caterpillars turn into butterflies. That is so amazing. Can you believe that? Butterflies are not born butterflies. No, they change from caterpillars. Oh my goodness, I still can't believe that. I still think about that every day. God is so amazing, the way He created the animals and the creatures and the way He creates us. And so before I talk to you more, I want to tell you what we're going to do, and I want you to get ready at home so you can help me with it. So the things we need for today, we need a plastic clear bottle. I bought this one in a dollar store and I emptied the water out. I drank the water and now I have a nice clear bottle for my experiment. Also, we need a measuring cup. This is cool. This is called a funnel. Have you seen one of these before? I love this. We're gonna use this today too. And also, we need a white balloon. I'm sure you're thinking, what do we need a balloon for? That's a good question. We need a black marker, and we need the vinegar and the baking soda, which I know we used before, so you know what that is. And today I have a tray because I want to not make a mess all over the table. This is a great way, boys and girls, of doing a science experiment. So maybe your mom and dad or your brother and sister has something like this in the house that you can use to do the science experiment with. So the first thing that I need us to do is to take our permanent marker and our balloon, and we're going to draw a caterpillar on one side of the balloon. So I'm just gonna draw it and then I'm gonna show you what it looks like just on one side of the balloon. So it should look like this. Now, I'm not great at drawing. I think you can tell that that's a caterpillar. It has a head and a body. And now I want you to turn the balloon over onto the other side and draw a butterfly. Make sure you give it four wings and a little antenna out of its head. That's right. If you're not sure how to draw a butterfly, you can even ask someone to help you. This is my butterfly. I'm not great at drawing, but I think I did a pretty good job. How is yours at home? If you need some help with your drawing, that's okay. You can ask someone to help you. So you should have a caterpillar on one side and a butterfly on the other side of the balloon. So what do we need to do next? Next, we need to take our vinegar and we need to take the lid off our bottle. I'm gonna put the bottle inside the tray. We're going to take the funnel. The funnel helps us to pour the vinegar into the bottle so that we don't make a mess. So I'm gonna pour some vinegar. Good job, I have the tray. I'm gonna pour the vinegar into the bottle. So boys and girls, you don't need to fill the bottle up with vinegar. You just put a little bit of vinegar in the bottom, okay? Now the next step is we need to take the balloon and put some baking soda, the white powder, inside the balloon. This is tricky. You might need someone to help you. We need to put the funnel inside the balloon. And you might need a spoon or something to help you. I'm gonna try using this and see whether it works. I'm gonna take a little bit of the baking powder. Oh, it's working. It's going inside the balloon. You can see it's filling up. This is so much fun. Okay, so I'm not filling up the balloon full. It's about halfway full right now. Okay, so that can happen. So some of it fell in the tray. That's why I have a tray. Now, this is really tricky. I need you to take your time with this step because we're going to put the balloon over the top of the hole, but we don't want the baking soda to pour into the bottle yet. So what I'm gonna do is hold onto the balloon, make sure the baking soda stays inside my hand, and at the same time, I'm going to put the balloon over the top of the bottle, just like that. So the caterpillar is the beginning of the life of the butterfly. The caterpillar doesn't look anything like the butterfly. The caterpillar kind of looks fairly ordinary. And that reminds me of me and you. When we say yes to Jesus and we ask him into our life, we're on the beginning of a journey. And maybe we're not who we need to be yet. Maybe there are things that we need to change in, and Jesus is great at that. He lives inside of us and he helps us to change, to become more holy, to do and say things that make him happy, and we become more like him. And we begin to transform into something beautiful, just like the butterfly. Because boys and girls, when the caterpillar turns into a butterfly, it has wings. The caterpillar doesn't have wings. It has to crawl along the floor. The butterfly has wings. Now the butterfly can fly and doesn't have to just stay on the ground, but can go up very, very, very high and see from far and travel really far as well. And that's just like my journey with Jesus and your journey with Jesus, because when you change and become more like Jesus, you turn into the beautiful person that Jesus created for you to be. And you go far, because everything you do, when Jesus is a part of it, it becomes big and it becomes beautiful, because anything that Jesus is in is beautiful. So just like the butterfly, you can also fly and fly high and do great things and make a great difference in your school and in your street with your neighbors and with your family. Boys and girls, you have Jesus in your life and you can be amazing for Jesus. And so that's why I wanted to share with you today this amazing story of the caterpillar and the butterfly, because it makes me think of me and you. And I want you now to see this incredible step of the science experiment. This is when it gets really exciting. So what we're going to do is we're going to lift up the balloon and let the baking soda go all the way into the vinegar. And when it mixes together, it's gonna make a reaction. And let's see what happens. Okay, are you ready? Okay, let's see. Ooh, boys and girls, look. That is so cool. And do you see the butterfly on the other side? Wow, boys and girls, look at the beautiful butterfly. The caterpillar turned into a butterfly. Well, this is a really fun experiment. I hope that you get to do this over and over again. You can try with different color balloons. And boys and girls, show to your parents and tell them the story of transformation and how when we grow up in God, we change and we become more holy and we become more faithful. God loves you. Have a beautiful day. God bless you.
Hello, children. I'm so glad you joined me for Bible time together. You know, the story that we're talking about today happened thousands and thousands of years ago. It was the days when the Egyptians were in charge of the Hebrews. And back then, there was a very mean king called the Pharaoh, and he didn't like the Hebrew people anymore. In fact, he wanted all the Hebrew boys to be thrown in the river when they were born. Let me read it to you. It's in Exodus chapter 2. And there was a man of the house of Levi, and he took a wife, and the woman had a baby. And when she had her son, she saw that he was a goodly child. And so she hid him for 3 months. Do you have a baby in your house? It is very hard to hide a baby because they go wah, wah all night and all day. It must have been very tough for that mama. But she did it until he was about 3 months old and she couldn't hide the baby anymore. So this is what she did. Do you know who I'm talking about? You're right. It's the story of Moses. So that mama went down to the river and she took some reeds, long, tall grass, and she wove a basket. And then she took mud and tar. The Bible says she covered it with slime and pitch. Slime was in the Bible thousands of years ago. Isn't that cool? She took slime and pitch and she covered this basket. The basket had a top and a bottom. And then she did something very surprising. She put the baby in the basket and she put the baby on the river. But that's not the end of the story. His sister, Miriam, stood far off and watched what would happen to the baby. She kept her eyes on that baby in that basket. They call it an ark because it was covered over. And she watched the river current take the baby basket closer and closer to where the princess, the daughter of Pharaoh, was bathing in the river. When the princess saw the basket, she told her servants, "Bring that over here." And when she opened the basket, there was Moses, but he was crying. As soon as Miriam saw the princess pick up the baby, she ran to the princess and said, "Shall I go and call thee a nurse, one of the Hebrew women, so that they may nurse the child?" And the princess, who was called Pharaoh's daughter, said, "Yes, go get me the woman." And Miriam ran and got Moses' mommy. And the princess said, "I will pay you to take care of this child." And so Moses' mommy took care of Moses with Miriam until Moses was old enough. And then Moses' mommy took Moses to the Egyptian palace. And there he lived until he was 40 years old, learning the ways of the palace. And if you know the rest of the story, you know that Moses was mightily used of God. And when he was 80 years old, he led over 1 million people out of Egypt to freedom. And it all started with a woman who believed that God would protect her son, and a little girl who kept her eye on that baby floating on the river until she saw what God would do. Isn't that amazing? I think it is too.
It's Bible time, little chickens. Kathleen, could you please read me a scripture?
Yes.
Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
Kathleen, what does that mean?
I think it means God's Leo, and we hope in him.
You know, Blet is Leo.
I can't see Blet, but I know it's Leo.
See, I could hold my Blet.
Better live. We need God to live too.
Hi, Jenny!
Hi, Polly. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm great too.
I have a question for you, Jenny.
What's your question?
Jenny, what does the word holy mean?
You mean like holy cannoli?
No.
Holy cow?
No.
Holy Toledo?
No.
What did you mean, holy?
I heard Aisha praying in the playground today, and she was praying to Holy God.
Oh, Holy God. Well, Holy God means God is special and set apart and never makes mistakes. He's perfect.
Who never makes mistakes? I always make mistakes.
Yeah, me too, Polly. But God is perfect. And he never makes mistakes. And when we pray to Holy God, we're remembering how awesome he is.
Jenny, I don't quite understand.
Okay, Polly, do you play a sport?
I play hockey, Jenny.
Ah, and when you play hockey, do you use the same hockey stick?
When I play hockey with my friends, I just use an old hockey stick.
All right, what about for the big game?
And for the big games, I have a special stick I got from my dad for Christmas.
Well, you know what? That's just like holiness, that your hockey stick was special for the big game. That's how we're supposed to be. We're supposed to be set apart or special for God. So that means sometimes we make choices that are different from everybody else. Like, if you're being holy as a hockey player, what would make you different?
Well, I wouldn't hit anybody.
Okay, that's a good start.
I wouldn't hit them with my stick or push them into the boards.
All right, well that's really good news, Polly. You know, I was thinking of another example of holiness. Are you ready?
I'm ready, Jenny.
All right, have you ever dressed up in really good clothes?
Like for what, Jenny?
Like, have you ever gone to a wedding or a baby baptism?
I've gone to a wedding, Jenny.
Okay, when you went to the wedding, did you wear your play clothes?
No, I had to wear a really good tight suit. It was so uncomfortable.
Polly, I've been there. But why do people dress up for a wedding, do you
know? I don't know. I have no idea, but the cookies were so good, I ate lots of them.
All right, Polly, it's because it's a special occasion. People dress up for weddings and for baby dedications and those kind of things because it's special, it's set apart. And so when you heard Aisha praying to Holy God, she was praying to the God who is holy and special and set apart, who's perfect, and he never makes mistakes. And you know what? The more you love God, the more holy you'll be. And me too.
Thank you, Jenny.
I'll talk to you later, Polly. Don't hit anybody in the next hockey game, okay?
I'll keep my stick on the ice.
Strong home to broken. I am living my faith. boys and girls, good to see you again. You know what? The theme for this week is growing up in God and being holy. I'm not really sure what holy means. I'm trying to figure it out. Do you know what that means? Well, I'm on a quest to find out.
Hey, is this holy? A basketball net? It has a hole in it. But is it holy? Well, I'm still on the search for what holy means. Hey, there's a lot of holes here. I'm not so sure. Let's keep looking. What about this bagel? Is this bagel holy? You know, boys and girls, I don't think being holy is about having a hole. I think I'm on the wrong track. Where can I go when I want to find out more about God? Oh my goodness, look! This is amazing. It says Holy Bible. You see, boys and girls, I knew the Bible would be the best place to look for things of God. And this Bible is a King James Version Bible. Sometimes it has really difficult words in it, like thee and thou. So I decided to look at another version to see what God says about being holy. And in Deuteronomy 14:2, it says, "For you are a people holy to the Lord your God." That means you're set apart. And the Lord has chosen you to be a people for his treasured possession out of all the peoples who are on the face of the earth. Wow, boys and girls, I think we found the answer.
Wow, boys and girls, so now we know what it is to be holy. It means to be set apart and be different because God has chosen us as his special treasure. Wow, that's amazing. He wants us to be his special treasure so that we can do his special work on the earth. So this week, boys and girls, I want you to go and be different, set apart and holy wherever you are, whether it be in school, whether it be in church, whether it be at home or in the park with your friends. Be like Jesus, be different, be holy, so God can use you for his good work on the earth. Okay, so until next time, have a great day. See you soon. Bye.
If I were a butterfly, I thank you, God, for giving me wings. Hi, Pastor Zara.
Hi, Zara. I was singing along with you. I love that song.
I do too. I'm playing dress up.
I
and
see.
I love it.
Oh my goodness, you look beautiful with your wings and your scepter and your crown. Can
guess
I play
I
with you too?
Well, first, just guess what I am.
Guess what you are.
Uh-huh.
I think I want you to tell me. What are you?
I am a butterfly princess.
A butterfly princess?
Uh-huh.
Wow.
Hey, do you want to dress up with me too?
I would love to play with you.
Okay.
Zara, what are we playing?
Well, first we're going to pretend to fly, and then we're going to be very royal, saying, "Bring me my supper," and then, I don't know, what do you think?
Well, Zara, it makes me think about being holy, like how God changes us.
Hold on, wait a minute. Oh, being holy?
Yeah, being holy. Being holy is about when Jesus comes into our life and he changes us.
Oh, I love Jesus.
Zara, Jesus changes you from ordinary into extraordinary.
Extraordinary? You mean supercalifragilisticexpialidocious awesome?
Yes, super, super special.
Oh.
And he makes you more and more beautiful.
More beautiful?
More beautiful.
I want to be more beautiful. So how do you become more beautiful with Jesus?
You just keep loving him and then he helps you to become more like him every day.
So being holy is becoming beautiful.
Like Jesus.
Like Jesus.
Yeah. And doing the things that make him happy and saying the things that make him happy, because that makes you beautiful, just like Jesus is beautiful.
Well, I am gonna get more beautiful, because I'm gonna get more holy, and how do I do that again?
By loving Jesus.
By loving Jesus! I can do that! I know I can do that!
And Jesus is the one that will change you. You just have to work on loving him more and more every day.
Okay! Alright! Let's learn how to fly!
Sounds good. After you.
Hi kids! Do you remember how last week we were talking about Holy Spirit and how you could be baptized with the Holy Spirit and move with power? Well, we want to talk to you about a famous woman. Now, this happened in the 1800s, and the lady's name was Maria Wordsworth Edder, and she was a powerful woman.
And she grew up and got to know Jesus when she was only 13. That was when she said yes to Jesus. And just after, she is said to have written that she heard the voice of Jesus calling her into the highways and the hedges to gather the lost sheep, which means that she had a heart to go and find those people that didn't know Jesus yet, tell them about Jesus so that they could also accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior.
So she was an evangelist.
Yes, she was.
The first time she wanted to preach, she was 35. Wow. And the elders prayed and sent her, but they sent her to one of the worst towns in the area. But she gathered friends around her, and they prayed and prayed and prayed. For 3 days they prayed.
Wow.
And then they went into the town, preached the gospel, and everybody got saved.
Everybody?
Yes. Isn't that amazing?
So she was really used by God.
She really was. In fact, she loved Holy Spirit so much that she would seek God for hours at a time, and then whatever Holy Spirit told her to do, she would do.
Sometimes there were as many as 6,000 seats, 6,000 people that would come into the tent where she would talk about Jesus.
She was pretty amazing. And you know what? She was a healing evangelist. And a healing evangelist is someone just like Prophet Shaiju Matthew, who went and preached the gospel in over 100 cities. And everywhere he went, the power of God would move for people to be healed. So Maria Wordsworth Edder, way back in the 1800s and early 1900s, flowed with healing power through the power of Jesus Christ.
Back then it was happening that people were getting healed, and today you're saying too that it happens even with Prophet Shaiju Matthew.
Yes, in fact, one time a few months ago, he had a word from the Lord that there was a woman in a hospital bed and that she should rise up from her bed and be healed. And do you know, that day she rose up from her hospital bed and was
healed.
She was out of the hospital, I think, the very next day.
That's amazing. But I have a question. What about the children that are watching? What about the boys and girls that are watching us? Can they also be used by the Holy Spirit today?
Absolutely. If you love Jesus and you ask the Holy Spirit to lead you, you can do many signs and wonders and powerful miracles right now. Now remember, sometimes, most often, there's a preparation process.
It's true, because Maria, she was saved at 13, but she started preaching when
she was 35.
Okay, so there was a time for her to train and get ready and be prepared.
Yep, and all through the Bible you see that. So kids, don't lose heart.
Yeah.
You can move in sign and wonders now, but trust the process and allow God to move you from being an ordinary caterpillar to an extraordinary butterfly.
That's true.
From moving from the natural life to the supernatural life.
Amen.
As you let your leaders lead you forward.
Amen.
Amen.
That's good.
Amen.
Hi kids, I just want to say praise the Lord.
Yay! Pastor Sarah, do you like being a butterfly princess?
Of course.
It's fun, kids. We hope you had fun today. And isn't it amazing, Pastor Sarah, how God changes us?
It is. Even when we don't even ask him to, he still comes and helps us to change.
Right.
I love that. I love that God's taking me from ordinary to extraordinary.
I love that He's taking me from natural to supernatural.
And I love that holiness and faithfulness is the way to get there.
It's amazing. Don't forget to like this video
and subscribe to our channel.
And check out in the description below our Facebook, Instagram, and our blog.
Very cool. Well, let's pray. Children, close your eyes or settle your hearts and let's lift up the name of our King. Holy God, we thank you that you are our God, that you're perfect in all your ways. And we want to be like Jesus, our King, more every day. Help us be royal. Help us transform or change into your image. Help us change from natural to supernatural. And help us be full of power by the Holy Spirit. And may every child who loves Jesus rise up and change the world. We pray this in your name, Jesus.
Amen.
See you next time.
Bye.